great game. Has the same character development and great storyline, just like the comic book and, of course, TV show, which is also based on the comic book. So if you're a fan of either one or both, then I'm sure you'll love this game. For those of you who have watched me play this through on my gaming channel, which I've now closed for various reasons, one of which is just to consolidate, move everything over here, especially for some of my earlier videos, which were not of great quality, gives me a chance to kind of perfect my playthroughs, so to speak. So, and we get to enjoy that game, and I already played it through, like I said, the first two or three episodes somewhat. And I wanted to give the game more exposure to those who have never seen it before. So now when we start the game, you can choose a regular standard user interface. Provides you with help and feedback for important choices, or minimal. Turn off the hints, the help, and the choice notification, which I prefer. So we're going to do that. And here we are, episode one, A New Day. This starts off just as the event happens, and you have a new character, which is the guy you just saw there. And a lot of, you bump into a couple of the characters from the comic book and the TV show. But it's really an incredible game. It's won some awards. I'm not sure which ones, but it's got great art direction, great story, great characters, really some touching moments. Very emotional, charged, powerful moments. A lot of crazy stuff happens, and it's just a great game all around. Just love the it's got almost a comic book feel to it.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
A limited amount of time to make a choice in your response. You get to actually shape the story to a degree, so how about, you know what they say about reckoning?
You know what they say about reckoning?
I don't, but I reckon it's a lot like assuming.
Yeah, something like that.
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
Not for me.
'Cause guys in your position already said it enough. I followed your case a little bit, you being a Macon boy and all.
You're from Macon, then?
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case, like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in, with all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
At the radio.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it, but that box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my sixth year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Sure.
But not really.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
Or she married the wrong guy.
You'll have to learn to stop worrying about things you can't control. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting. Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. Not tell him he's got to stop, but that's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it? Maybe he was innocent.
Maybe he was innocent.
Innocent? They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so. This other time...
Basically, you control your character with the left stick and the right stick to just look around, and you use the buttons to do certain actions.
Hey! Hey, officer! Are you alright? I'm still cuffed back here! Officer?
Oh, that doesn't look good. He wasn't ejected from the car. He's not moving. He must have the handcuff keys on him. Why the hell did he have his gun out?
And there's a lot, somewhat interaction like this all throughout the game, looking for certain objects. So it has some RPG elements a little bit.
Damn it.
So there's a little bit of a beginning tutorial like most games have.
I need to drag myself out that window.
And this is the character we play. So it's a new character, new lead character, new storyline. Lots of great characters all throughout the game. Interesting characters. Great environment. our direction.
The officer's shotgun is over there. Looks empty. It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off.
And over here is a shotgun shell. We're able to pick that up. And of course, this doesn't look good. There's no zombies around, or walkers around, I should say.
Officer? God damn.
Let's get a little closer. He looks. And you can walk away if you want with that arrow pointing that way. And there's the key, so let's take the keys and get our cuffs off.
Shit.
Of course. Let's try again.
Holy shit!
And we're just gonna back up here.
What in the hell? What the fuck are you? Get away from me!
Where's that shotgun? Let's grab that.
The hell are you? Shit!
I love it.
Let me do this!
Horror film type elements, you know, dropping the ammo. Blew his brains out.
Man. His skin's all rotten and he smells like shit. Is this? Are you dead? Hey! Are you dead?
That's like the funniest thing, because, you know, he just blew his brains out, so. But I guess after what happened, it's just in a state of shock. Let's see, what's that up there?
Help! Go get someone! There's been a shooting!
So let's see, we figure out what to do here. Take a look over here. Oh, trouble. It's time to bombinos. This is what I like about the game. The cutscenes and everything are in-game graphics. So everything has a nice flow and ebb and flow. Ebb and flow to it. Saved by the bell or gunshot.
Hello, anybody?
And that is gonna do it for this episode. next episode and play this game through in its entirety. It's one of my favorites. I know a lot of folks like it. Whether you play the game or not, if you're looking for a Walking Dead experience and fix until the TV show comes back on, well, hopefully this will fill that void. It's going to be a lot of gameplay, so it's quite a long game. I'll try to have these out. I'm hoping we'll see. Once or twice a week, hopefully maybe twice. Alright, well, thanks for watching, and we're going to pick it right up here in the next episode. Until next time,
somebody
tingle on.
Yell if you can hear me!